My dad is Arthur Hodgson. He died at 94 in 2010. And his best friend, John McDonald, had the good fortune of meeting the fellow who was running these. It was called Dram Hill, I don't know why. And they were running at Skeeto there in 1947, and the man was having a bad time, so they took it over. And they got a car engine out of a Buick, I think, and they rigged it all up, and they decided they would have two toes on each side of the pole, and that's why it's called Twin Toes, to get more people up the hill. They got some old, used telephone poles from Wilton Telephone and I think PS&H. And so they used those, and then somehow they got the wheels, you know, that the rope would go on. And so there was, as I remember, there was a telephone pole, and then there probably was a bar and the wheel on each side, you know, wide. So some kids went up this side and some kids went up that side. They ran it from 1947 to 1964, or somewhere in those ranges. In my day, I think it was $1 to go to ski there for the day. So kids could come with $1 and a quarter, and they could ski all day and get a hot dog and a candy bar and a drink. So it was very, very popular. I mean, I talk to people today who live in Nashua and Peterborough, and they say, oh, I spent my childhood there. You know, I learned to ski there. It was so much fun. I was one of the younger kids, and I never did. The kids would just go straight up and down as fast as they could go. And I never dared to do that. I never dared to go straight down. So there was another telephone pole off to the left, and I would go over, and everybody did. There was a big track over to the pole and then down. And then one day, somebody challenged me, you know, oh, you're a baby. You can't do it. So I went straight all the way down, petrified the whole time, and I made it. So after that, I didn't have to go around the corner anymore. Picture the most beautiful winter day, the most beautiful snow. I mean, every child in the area was there. And I just remember this. The motor wouldn't be able to handle it, you know, so you'd start going slower and slower up the hill. And then I think that they would have to make people get off. You know, you'd have to let go and go off on the side so the motor could catch up again and pull the people up. In the springtime, the snow would melt, of course, and there'd be a huge pond at the bottom of the hill because it kind of was a depression. And the kids would, we all would, start at the top and see if we could skim across it, which, of course, we would end up, you know, in it, soaking wet. Thinking about the simplicity of those days, you know, that compared to today. I mean, today the technical stuff of ski boots and skis and the helmets and all of it. I mean, we would just throw on our old wool ski pants that the snow all stuck to and our knitted mittens and out we'd go. And it was great.